the Catholic people, and he spoke. They persecuted, and the Catholic people also persecuted them. But look at both of them here today. And then I said, you children and seraphim, is that where you're coming from? He said, yes. When you came out of the Anglican church, you thought Anglican was not praying and fasting enough. And then you were throwing bombshell at them. Didn't you do that? He said, yes. I said, you there, CAC, Christ Apostolic Church, when you came out of the Apostolic Church, didn't you feel that because they were not they were using medicine and you feel you are going to trust in God, you'll never taste medicine in your life, didn't you oppose them? They said they did. And then I said, when Deeper Life started, we saw that, you know what we had, that's why I call it Deeper Life. The rest didn't have. And just like Anglican fought against Catholic, like Chimera Seraphim, you fought against Anglican, and like CAC, they fought against, against the Apostolic Church, I said, I just did what you did. What you sowed is what you reaped. Like you opposed all the other churches, I also opposed you. Only I put my own in writing. He said he understood. Then I said, but this is a new day. That I don't say that again. That now everything is all right. You know what? Immediately, that man invited our state overseer to his church. And said, come and preach. But please understand, when he said, come and preach, our overseer told me, he said, the white garment man who confronted you that day, he has now invited me again. That's a gate man. You see, you need to understand. If you understand this, the gate man, and all these people are there not hearing the word of salvation, and he is inviting us to come and talk to them. And those other people, the concept they have, when you come to church, you don't wear shoe. When you come to church, this is how to behave, for them to know you have a message from God. And they will refer to the scriptures that God told Moses to take off his shoes. He told Joshua, take off your shoes. We don't do that. Now for me, I'm different because of the stature and because of what they know that God does with me. I can go anywhere and they accept me the way I am. So I told our overseer, please, when you go there, all those people watching you, whether you put on your shoes or not, the first thing you do without their telling you, remove your shoes. What if the overseer told me and said, GS, what are you telling me? I will never compromise in my life. I will never do that. And since we need to teach them, but you don't clean the fish before you catch the fish. If you want to clean the fish before you catch the fish, you'll never catch any fish. Which fish will remain there and stay there for you to clean it up before you catch it? You catch the fish first before you clean up the fish. And so he went. When he got there, by the time they just got to, the building, he just removed his shoes without they telling him. It opened them up and they said, what, you Deeper Life man, and with everything you have written against us before, now you come and you've done this. He said, how long should I pray? They said, just go on. Anything you want to say. Look at that. But what if he said, not so, Lord, I can never do that. You will miss out on this new day. If you're still staying back there, criticizing everything that is going on, and you say, look at this and look at this, you're going to lose a lot. But if you'll say, oh Lord, whatever you want to do, who is going to look at all the knowledge you have? Look at all the messages you are hearing. Look at the great deposit of revelation in Deeper Life, in your life, in your heart. And then because of tradition, and because of this, this and that, you're not going to take this revelation out there where people are waiting. And you're still standing by the side of Peter. Not so, Lord. I pray you will not miss out. You know what happened eventually? As we got to the program, and I had to pay courtesy call to the Archbishop. And not only that, I had to pay courtesy call to they call them Siriki, that is the chief, the king of that land, of the native people there. And when we got there, all the people were sitting on the ground, but I told you they gave me some special attention and some special privilege. They gave me a chair to sit on. And then the King Chio was sitting on a chair. And eventually, as all those people were sitting down with their turbans and everything. And so they spoke in their local language, interpreted to English, and told me to talk. How would you approach that situation? I'm telling you so that you don't miss out in this new day. Here is a man that is in charge of all that community, and here is, from the other religion. And I was sitting down together, and, all these people are there, and now he says I should talk. And I said, thank you very much. I gave him the respect that the title demands. And I then said, here we are today, creatures of the same creator. I didn't start with Calvary and Jesus and all these other things. I said, we're creatures of the same creator. He created us. And how is the creator looking at us now as we are fighting one another? And these are our boys, boys on my side and boys on your side, because of they don't understand. They are out there fighting one another. Here we are, we're sitting down together here. And those boys, I said, they don't know how united we are because we are from the same creator. He said, that is true. And then I spoke. And when I finished speaking, I said, now, you know what? I didn't say we're having crusade. I said we're having a kind of gathering together, social gathering. Where you're going to have a lot of your people are there. They're going to come to that social gathering tonight. Instead of saying they're going to come to crusade tonight. And I said, You don't want to hear what you are telling your people if we are brainwashing them. And we are telling them to fight against your authority and government. Here you are in the palace, you don't know what we are telling your people. Why don't you come out? A leader must be near to his people. He said, yes, that is true. And so eventually he agreed he'll come out. And then I said, not only that, we are having a special meeting with senators and directors and, politicians Sunday night. That was to be about 2 days after. And I said, you'll meet a lot of people there. And some of the people, they're decision makers. The people to construct your road and the people to do this. And he said, yes, this is true. I said, if you keep yourself away from these decision makers, you're going to lose a lot. I didn't tell him, you come to crusade. I put another way. If we don't know how to approach people today, this new day, and you're still with the old concept, I pray you will not lose out. And then eventually, when I finished, I did as if I wanted to stand up, because Jesus, he was going, and then he did as if he'll pass them by. Then he made the people say, don't go, stay with us. And sometimes you have to make them show their desire. So I stood up. He said, you cannot go yet. I said, what else remains? He said, you must pray for us. I didn't impose the prayer on him. He said, you must pray for us. And then we prayed. After we prayed, he said,
you have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the whole word and you will let them sink into your hearts. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.